case for the president, forcing him to use the emergency exit, and Donald Trump doesn't waste a minute noticing it.
You know, it's interesting with the president, because I saw that yesterday with the stairs. He went to Saudi Arabia and the top people didn't greet him, right? He went to Cuba and Castro, the brother, was not there to greet him. And I said to myself, you know, if that happened, I'd land, I'd hear he's not there to pay respect to the country, not to him, to pay respect to our country. I would say, thank you very much, fellas. That's okay. Close it up. Boom. Let's go back to Washington. I would.
So is Trump right or wrong? Hi, everybody. I'm David Asman. Welcome to Forbes on Fox. Let's go in focus to find out with Steve Forbes, Rich Karlgaard, Elizabeth McDonald, Mike Gozanian, John Tamney, and Bruce Jaffson. Steve, what do you think?
Trump on this is absolutely right. What the Chinese did was inexcusable, but it shows their contempt for him. It was a slap in the face. One Chinese official chuckled and said he had to leave the rear end of the plane. He used a more graphic description of it. And so Trump should have done what Reagan did in the past. If something's not done right, walk away. But it shows that the world is becoming more dangerous when the Chinese treat that president like that.
And Bruce, it's this whole idea of soft diplomacy, which President Obama has sort of championed, versus hard diplomacy, which Donald Trump stands for. You look at this nuclear explosion that North Korea set off this week. I mean, this is in direct defiance of President Obama's nuclear test ban proposal. So all of the soft diplomacy doesn't get us a lot.
Well, I mean, first of all, the soft diplomacy, I beg to differ on that with Trump, you know, snuggling up to Putin this week and doing interviews on Russian TV. So I don't know what that's, the hard diplomacy is there. But I would say President Obama, it's part of a strategy in Asia. I mean, he was the first president to go to Laos, I think, ever. And he's been over there in the whole region. And I think that the Chinese are worried about that. I don't think that they're snubbing us so much as that they're worried about the relationships
but
he's building.
Mike, the question is, what does it get us in the end? They had a communique at the end of this meeting in China. There was nothing substantive about really critical issues like the militarization of those islands in the South China Sea. I mean, you see what's happening there. That's a threat to all of the people that live in that region. Also, the Chinese protectionism, nothing about that in there. So what has this gotten us?
Yeah, well, this has been Obama's approach, David, throughout his presidency. I mean, even for things like the Olympics, when he flew to Europe to try to get the Olympics to Chicago, they laughed him back to Chicago. You know, it's okay to speak softly, but as Teddy Roosevelt said, you got to carry a big stick.
Right.
Unfortunately, President Obama has a tiny, tiny stick.
And Rich, also, there's a question of symbolism, and it does matter in diplomacy, particularly in places like China. When the president got off of the tarmac, or as he was preparing to, there was this big furor between these Chinese reps wagging their fingers saying, this is our country, our airport. And that's what led, that's one of the things that led Trump to say he would have just flown away.
You know, when I first heard Trump make those remarks, I thought it was a hot-headed overreaction. But I have to say that I've come around to the point of view, particularly, you know, with the subsequent comments of the Chinese, that Trump, maybe silly symbolism, but Trump has to, and the U.S. president has to show strength, if it's real or symbolic. And Obama's been pushed around the world map like you've never seen. Even the president of the Philippines, you know, within the last week, called him a son of a whore.
Unbelievable stuff. Of course, the president canceled his side trip to the Philippines because of that. But EMAC, as Steve already mentioned, Ronald Reagan thought symbolism was important. There was this meeting in Iceland with the Soviet leader at the time, Gorbachev. President Reagan walked out of that meeting when he thought he was doing the fast step, the Russian leader, and he ended up ending the Cold War.
Yeah,
I mean, that was significant.
That's right, David. It happened in 1986. It was a dramatic and spontaneous moment when Reagan stood up and walked out. It was over eliminating U.S. and Soviet nuclear arsenals. And you know what? In Gorbachev's inner circles, it was understood that it created a new trust between Gorbachev and Reagan. When Reagan did that, they had a new understanding. And Gorbachev started to speak differently about Ronald Reagan. It changed dramatically the events of the Cold War.
Well, and John, again, symbolism. We saw a little bit of soft power symbolism at the beginning of Hillary Clinton's stint as Secretary of State when she gave the Russian foreign minister, her counterpart, one of these buttons. That was supposed to be the reset button. That didn't turn out too well, did it?
Well, I'm not too worried about this. The reality is China's people or its government may not treat our leaders well, but its companies line up to serve our needs on a daily basis. We are number one. As for how our politicians are treated, I like when they're cut down to size. I think this is healthy. We need to stop holding them in such high regard.
Well, I see Mike almost jumping out of his chair. Go ahead, Jose.
I think John is so off on this. Look, one of the reasons why the Republican Party did not want Ronald Reagan to become president is because our companies were doing big business with Russia and other countries. And Ronald Reagan said, I'm sorry, I'm going to stop this. And he built up our military. They had to pay respect to us. Ronald Reagan cared about Main Street Americans and the safety of this country, and not just our big corporations and not just the big business they do in China.
Well, and Steve, the point is that China does have, we all love free trade, but China is very protectionist. We let in all their goods. They don't let a lot in their own country.
Well, and there were remedies in place, David, to take care of these kinds of infractions of trade agreements, violations, and there's cyber stealing is rampant. We have measures we could use against them. But if you let them get away with it, they're just going to do more. And with this president, when he says there'll be consequences, everyone knows that means there'll be no consequences, and they can continue to push us around.
Well, by the way, Bruce, you mentioned that Trump had some relations with Putin speaking, and that's true. He was speaking very kindly of Putin this week. But of course, Hillary has a lot of connections we've explored before with Russia. But despite the connections that may or may not be true with Trump and Hillary Clinton, China seemed to get along wonderfully. They didn't put out the red carpet for President Obama, but they rolled it right out for Putin. Look at this.
Yeah, I mean, who knows? I mean, first of all, back to the red carpet, I believe we take our own red carpet around the world. That's one of the things I discovered under this, and I don't really view this as a big deal. But Trump's continued snuggling up to Russia are problematic, and that's why we need to see his tax return, because we need to see where his investments are in all of this.
Emac, what about John Tammany's point that, look, the commercial interests will always trump diplomacy and hard-knock diplomacy?
I'm not so sure about that. I think that, you know, listen, we have a crisis in how we govern ourselves, and, you know, what's problematic is how President Obama has been talking down America. America has been a dramatic force for good and hope in the world. The people around the world look to us for security and for freedom. We're a beacon of hope. Yeah. For the president to continuously talk America down is so bad. And I also agree with Bruce. Trump needs to release his tax returns. There's problems there. We need to see if there's a Russia connection.
I don't want to get in that kettle. But final word, Rich, on the idea of commercial interest trumping diplomacy, whether it's soft or hard diplomacy.
I think John Tammany, much as I love John Tammany, underestimates China's ambition to reassert itself as the preeminent civilization on Earth, a position it once had and had fallen very far from. They are hugely ambitious
John,
about this.
I'm getting a wrap, but I got to give you the final word. Go ahead, because you're getting beat up on here.
Free trading countries are not at war. It's the cheapest foreign policy. Okay. I'm hearing a lot of nonsense. They're not trying
Mike for the president, forcing him to use the emergency exit, and Donald Trump doesn't waste a minute noticing it.
You know, it's interesting with the president, because I saw that yesterday with the stairs. He went to Saudi Arabia and the top people didn't greet him, right? He went to Cuba and Castro, the brother, was not there to greet him. And I said to myself, you know, if that happened, I'd land, I'd hear he's not there to pay respect to the country, not to him, to pay respect to our country. I would say, thank you very much, fellas. That's okay. Close it up. Boom. Let's go back to Washington. I will.
So is Trump right or wrong? Hi, everybody. I'm David Asman. Welcome to Forbes on Fox. Let's go in focus to find out with Steve Forbes, Rich Karlgaard, Elizabeth McDonald, Mike Ozanian, John Tammany, and Bruce Jafson. Steve, what do you think?
Trump on this is absolutely right. What the Chinese did was inexcusable, but it shows their contempt for him. It was a slap in the face. One Chinese official chuckled and said he had to leave the rear end of the plane. He used a more graphic description of it. And so Trump should have done what Reagan did in the past. If something's not done right, walk away. But it shows that the world is becoming more dangerous when the Chinese treat that president like that.
And Bruce, it's this whole idea of soft diplomacy, which President Obama has sort of championed, versus hard diplomacy, which Donald Trump stands for. You look at this nuclear explosion that North Korea set off this week. I mean, this is in direct defiance of President Obama's nuclear test ban proposal. So all of the soft diplomacy doesn't get us a lot.
Well, I mean, first of all, the soft diplomacy, I beg to differ on that with Trump, you know, snuggling up to Putin this week and doing interviews on Russian TV. So I don't know what that's, the hard diplomacy is there. But I would say President Obama, it's part of a strategy in Asia. I mean, he was the first president to go to Laos, I think, ever. And he's been over there in the whole region. And I think that the Chinese are worried about that. I don't think that they're snubbing us so much as that they're worried about the relationships
but
he's building.
Mike, the question is, what does it get us in the end? They had a communique at the end of this meeting in China. There was nothing substantive about really critical issues like the militarization of those islands in the South China Sea. I mean, you see what's happening there. That's a threat to all of the people that live in that region. Also, the Chinese protectionism, nothing about that in there. So what has this gotten us?
Yeah, well, this has been Obama's approach, David, throughout his presidency. I mean, even for things like the Olympics, when he flew to Europe to try to get the Olympics to Chicago, they laughed him back to Chicago. You know, it's okay to speak softly, but as Teddy Roosevelt said, you got to carry a big stick.
Right.
Unfortunately, President Obama has a tiny, tiny stick.
And Rich, also, there's a question of symbolism, and it does matter in diplomacy, particularly in places like China. When the president got off of the tarmac, or as he was preparing to, there was this big furor between these Chinese reps wagging their fingers saying, this is our country, our airport. And that's what led Trump, that's one of the things that led Trump to say he would have just flown away.
You know, when I first heard Trump make those remarks, I thought it was a hot-headed overreaction. But I have to say that I've come around to the point of view, particularly, you know, with the subsequent comments of the Chinese, that Trump, maybe silly symbolism, but Trump has to, and the U.S. president has to show strength, if it's real or symbolic. And Obama's been pushed around the world map like you've never seen. Even the president of the Philippines, you know, within the last week, called him a son of a whore.
Unbelievable stuff. Of course, the president canceled his side trip to the Philippines because of that. But EMAC, as Steve already mentioned, Ronald Reagan thought symbolism was important. There was this meeting in Iceland with the Soviet leader at the time, Gorbachev. President Reagan walked out of that meeting when he thought he was doing the fast step, the Russian leader, and he ended up ending the Cold War.
Yeah,
I mean, that was significant.
That's right, David. It happened in 1986. It was a dramatic and spontaneous moment when Reagan stood up and walked out. It was over eliminating U.S. and Soviet nuclear arsenals. And you know what? In Gorbachev's inner circles, it was understood that it created a new trust between Gorbachev and Reagan. When Reagan did that, they had a new understanding. And Gorbachev started to speak differently about Ronald Reagan. It changed dramatically the events of the Cold War.
Well, and John, again, symbolism. We saw a little bit of soft power symbolism at the beginning of Hillary Clinton's stint as Secretary of State when she gave the Russian foreign minister, her counterpart, one of these buttons. That was supposed to be the reset button. That didn't turn out too well, did it?
Well, I'm not too worried about this. The reality is China's people or its government may not treat our leaders well, but its companies line up to serve our needs on a daily basis. We are number one. As for how our politicians are treated, I like when they're cut down to size. I think this is healthy. We need to stop holding them in such high regard.
Well, I see Mike almost jumping out of his chair. Go ahead, Jose.
I think John is so off on this. Look, one of the reasons why the Republican Party did not want Ronald Reagan to become president is because our companies were doing big business with Russia and other countries. And Ronald Reagan said, I'm sorry, I'm going to stop this. And he built up our military. They had to pay respect to us. Ronald Reagan cared about Main Street Americans and the safety of this country,
and
not just our big corporations and not just the big business they do in
China. Well, and Steve, the point is that China does have, we all love free trade, but China is very protectionist. We let in all their goods. They don't let a lot in their own country.
Well, and there were remedies in place, David, to take care of these kinds of infractions of trade agreements, violations, and there's cyber stealing is rampant. We have measures we could use against them. But if you let them get away with it, they're just going to do more. And with this president, when he says there'll be consequences, everyone knows that means there'll be no consequences, and they can continue to push us around.
Well, by the way, Bruce, you mentioned that Trump had some relations with Putin, speaking, and that's true. He was speaking very kindly of Putin this week. But, of course, Hillary has a lot of connections we've explored before with Russia. But despite the connections that may or may not be true with Trump and Hillary Clinton, China seemed to get along wonderfully. They didn't put out the red carpet for President Obama, but they rolled it right out for Putin. Look at this.
Yeah, I mean, who knows? I mean, first of all, back to the red carpet, I believe we take our own red carpet around the world. That's one of the things I discovered under this, and I don't really view this as a big deal. But Trump's continued snuggling up to Russia are problematic, and that's why we need to see his tax return, because we need to see where his investments are in all of this.
Emac, what about John Tamney's point that, look, the commercial interest will always trump diplomacy and hard-knock diplomacy?
I'm not so sure about that. I think that, you know, listen, we have a crisis in how we govern ourselves, and, you know, what's problematic is how President Obama has been talking down America. America has been a dramatic force for good and hope in the world. People around the world look to us for security and for freedom. We're a beacon of hope. Yeah. For the president to continuously talk America down is so bad. And I also agree with Bruce. Trump needs to release his tax returns. There's problems there. We need to see if there's a Russia connection.
I want to get in that kettle. But final word, Rich, on the idea of commercial interest trumping diplomacy, whether it's soft or hard diplomacy.
I think John Tamney, much as I love John Tamney, underestimates China's ambition to reassert itself as the preeminent civilization on Earth, a position it once had and had fallen very far from. They are hugely ambitious about this.
John, I'm getting a wrap, but I got to give you the final word. Go ahead, because you're getting beat up on here.
Free trading countries are not at war. It's the cheapest foreign policy. Okay. I'm hearing a lot of nonsense. They're not trying
to kill us. They're stealing resources.
They're trying to serve us.
Last word, Mike Waters, for the president, forcing him to use the emergency exit, and Donald Trump doesn't waste a minute noticing it.
You know, it's interesting with the president, because I saw that yesterday with the stairs. He went to Saudi Arabia and the top people didn't greet him, right? He went to Cuba and Castro, the brother, was not there to greet him. And I said to myself, you know, if that happened, I'd land, I'd hear he's not there to pay respect to the country, not to him, to pay respect to our country. I would say, thank you very much, fellas. That's okay. Close it up. Boom. Let's go back to Washington. I would.
So is Trump right or wrong? Hi, everybody. I'm David Asman. Welcome to Forbes on Fox. Let's go in focus to find out with Steve Forbes, Rich Karlgaard, Elizabeth McDonald, Mike Gozanian, John Tamney, and Bruce Jafson. Steve, what do you think?
Trump on this is absolutely right. What the Chinese did was inexcusable, but it shows their contempt for him. It was a slap in the face. One Chinese official chuckled and said he had to leave the rear end of the plane. He used a more graphic description of it. And so Trump should have done what Reagan did in the past. If something's not done right, walk away. But it shows that the world is becoming more dangerous when the Chinese treat that president like that.
And Bruce, it's this whole idea of soft diplomacy, which President Obama has sort of championed, versus hard diplomacy, which Donald Trump stands for. You look at this nuclear explosion that North Korea set off this week. I mean, this is in direct defiance of President Obama's nuclear test ban proposal. So all of the soft diplomacy doesn't get us a lot.
Well, I mean, first of all, the soft diplomacy, I beg to differ on that with Trump, you know, snuggling up to Putin this week and doing interviews on Russian TV. So I don't know what the hard diplomacy is there. But I would say President Obama, it's part of a strategy in Asia. I mean, he was the first president to go to Laos, I think, ever. And he's been over there in the whole region. And I think that the Chinese are worried about that. I don't think that they're snubbing us so much as that they're worried about the relationships he's building.
The question is, what does it get us in the end? They had a communique at the end of this meeting in China. There was nothing substantive about really critical issues like the militarization of those islands in the South China Sea. I mean, you see what's happening. happening there. That's a threat to all of the people that live in that region. Also, the Chinese protectionism, nothing about that in there. So what has this gotten us?
Yeah, well, this has been Obama's approach, David, throughout his presidency. I mean, even for things like the Olympics, when he flew to Europe to try to get the Olympics to Chicago, they laughed him back to Chicago. You know, it's okay to speak softly, but as Teddy Roosevelt said, you got to carry a big stick.
Right.
Unfortunately, President Obama has a tiny, tiny stick.
And, Rich, also there's a question of symbolism, and it does matter in diplomacy, particularly in places like China. When the president got off of the tarmac, or as he was preparing to, there was this big furor between these Chinese reps wagging their fingers, saying, this is our country, our airport. And that's what led, that's one of the things that led Trump to say he would have just flown away.
You know, when I first heard Trump make those remarks, I thought it was a hot-headed overreaction. But I have to say that I've come around to the point of view, particularly, you know, with the subsequent comments of the Chinese, that Trump, maybe silly symbolism, but Trump has to, and the U.S. president has to show strength, if it's real or symbolic. And Obama's been pushed around the world map like you've never seen. Even the president of the Philippines, you know, within the last week, called him a son of a whore.
Unbelievable stuff. Of course, the president canceled his side trip to the Philippines because of that. But EMAC, as Steve already mentioned, Ronald Reagan thought symbolism was important. There was this meeting in Iceland with the Soviet leader at the time, Gorbachev. President Reagan walked out of that meeting when he thought he was doing a fast step, the Russian leader, and he ended up ending the Cold War.
Yeah,
I mean, that was significant.
That's right, David. It happened in 1986. It was a dramatic and spontaneous moment when Reagan stood up and walked out. It was over eliminating U.S. and Soviet nuclear arsenals. And you know what? In Gorbachev's inner circles, it was understood that it created a new trust between Gorbachev and Reagan. When Reagan did that, they had a new understanding, and Gorbachev started to speak differently about Ronald Reagan. It changed dramatically the events of the Cold War.
Well, and John, again, symbolism. We saw a little bit of soft power symbolism at the beginning of Hillary Clinton's stint as Secretary of State when she gave the Russian foreign minister, her counterpart, one of these buttons. That was supposed to be the reset button. That didn't turn out too well, did it?
Well, I'm not too worried about this. The reality is China's people or its government may not treat our leaders well, but its companies line up to serve our needs on a daily basis. We are number one. As for how our politicians are treated, I like when they're cut down to size. I think this is healthy. We need to stop holding them in such high regard.
Well, I see Mike almost jumping out of his chair. Go ahead, Jose.
I think John is so off on this. Look, one of the reasons why the Republican Party did not want Ronald Reagan to become president is because our companies were doing big business with Russia and other countries. And Ronald Reagan said, I'm sorry, I'm going to stop this. And he built up our military. They had to pay respect to us. Ronald Reagan cared about Main Street Americans and the safety of this country,
and
not just our big corporations and not just the big business they do in
Steve,
China.
Well, the point is that China does have, we all love free trade, but China is very protectionist. We let in all their goods. They don't let a lot in their own country.
Well, and there were remedies in place, David, to take care of these kinds of infractions of trade agreements, violations, and there's cyber stealing is rampant. We have measures we could use against them. But if you let them get away with it, they're just going to do more. And there was this president, when he says there'll be consequences, everyone knows that means there'll be no consequences, and they can continue to push us around.
Well, by the way, Bruce, you mentioned that Trump had some relations with Putin speaking, and that's true. He was speaking very kindly of Putin this week. But, of course, Hillary has a lot of connections we've explored before with Russia. But despite the connections that may or may not be true with Trump and Hillary Clinton, China seemed to get along wonderfully. They didn't put out the red carpet for President Obama, but they rolled it right out for Putin. Look at this.
Yeah, I mean, who knows? I mean, first of all, back to the red carpet, I believe we take our own red carpet around the world. That's one of the things I discovered under this, and I don't really view this as a big deal. But Trump's continued snuggling up to Russia are problematic. And that's why we need to see his tax return, because we need to see where his investments are in all of this.
Emac, what about John Tammany's point that, look, the commercial interest will always trump diplomacy and hard-knock diplomacy?
I'm not so sure about that. I think that, listen, we have a crisis in how we govern ourselves. And, what's problematic is how President Obama has been talking down America. America has been a dramatic force for good and hope in the world. People around the world look to us for security and for freedom. We're a beacon of hope. Yeah. For the president to continuously talk America down is so bad. And I also agree with Bruce. Trump needs to release his tax returns. There's problems there. We need to see if there's a Russia connection.
I want to get in that kettle. But final word, Rich, on the idea of commercial interest trumping diplomacy, whether it's soft or hard diplomacy.
I think John Tammany, much as I love John Tammany, underestimates China's ambition to reassert itself as the preeminent civilization on Earth, a position it once had and had fallen very far from. They are hugely ambitious
John,
about this.
I'm getting a wrap, but I got to give you the final word. Go ahead, because you're getting beat up on here.
Free trading countries are not at war. It's the cheapest foreign policy. Okay. I'm hearing a lot of nonsense. They're not trying
to kill us. They're stealing resources.
They're trying to serve us.
Last word, Mike.